Next, we're going to explain economic growth with our production possibility curve, PPC. So we know economic growth occurs if you get more resources. We know resources are land, labor, capital, and entrepreneurial ability. Or if you have better technology. So think about technology like Zoom. With Zoom, you're able to learn a similar class remotely, saving your transportation time. Or we're talking about self-checkout kiosk, so you can check out more people with fewer labors. And finally, we are all familiar with Ford's assembly line. He just reassigned the text with his labors, and he was able to complete the assembly lot faster. So economic growth happens if we have more resources or if we have better technology. Now, one resource that's really important for growth will be capital. So what is capital? Capital is any kind of factory, machinery, equipment that helps you to produce more goods and services. That will be capital. And to produce more capital, that means you will have to sacrifice some consumption goods. So for example, don't think about production possibility curve. Think about yourself. Suppose you are designing websites for companies and you make money that way. And you receive a, say, $3,000 tax return. There are two ways you can spend this $3,000. One is that you can buy a new computer. So the computer is going to help you to design websites faster, so you'll be able to make more money in the future. Or you can use this $3,000 to have a nice occasion in Hawaii. So which one do you choose? There is no right or wrong answer. If you choose to buy a new computer to produce more websites in the future, that means you choose capital goods. If you choose to go to Hawaii, that means you choose the consumption goods. Now, you cannot have both. It's one or the other. If you choose capital good, the computer, then you're going to have a higher income in the future. If you choose to go to Hawaii, then your income growth is not going to be as high as if you choose to purchase that computer. Now, the society will have to make the same choice. So suppose in our society, we have only two goods, pizza or robots, and we have our production possibility curve here. If you want more pizza, that means you will have fewer robots. If you choose more robots, you will have fewer pizza. Now we know pizza is a consumption good, and the robots will be the capital goods. So if you choose point A, that means you choose to have more robots and fewer pizza. That's kind of similar to our previous slide. We said you choose to buy a computer and forego your Hawaii trip. If you choose point B, that means you choose to have more pizza and fewer robots. That's kind of similar to our previous slide. You choose to have vacation in Hawaii. If you choose point A, I mean, our society choose to have more robots, that's the capital goods, and fewer consumption goods, then we will have a higher economic growth in the future. If we choose point B, that means we choose to have more pizza now, and that's more enjoyment for now, that means that we will have a little bit less economic growth in the future. The economy will still grow because, hey, we still have robots, we still have capital goods. But the growth will not be as high as if you choose point A. So let's take a look. If you choose point A, your economic growth will be big. If you choose B, that means more consumption goods and less capital goods, that means you will have a smaller growth. So that's how we look at our economic growth by looking at production possibility curve. Now to summarize, if you have two countries with exactly the same production possibility curve, depending on their choice, they could have a different growth rate in the future. So if you choose more capital goods and less consumption goods, then you're going to have less enjoyment for now, but you will have a more higher economic growth in the future. But if you choose more consumption goods now, then you enjoy more now, but you will have a little bit lower economic growth in the future.